Thank you. Thank you. If I could have your attention for one moment, please. Firstly, you're all very, very welcome here today to Griffith College. Before the ceremony commences, and for your safety and comfort, I'd like to draw your attention to some details on safety. There are 7 exits in the auditorium, 3 emergency exits at the rear of the auditorium, and 4 at the front of the auditorium. In the likely event of an emergency, please proceed directly and calmly to the exit that is nearest to you. When exiting the building, please do not use the lift. Once outside the building, you are then asked to proceed to Assembly Point G at the corner of the green area just over here. This area is marked by green signage. In preparation for the ceremony, I would ask guests to please turn off their mobile phones. Now, can I ask all guests to please stand for the graduation procession, please? if you can all remain standing for the academic procession. Thank you.
Please be seated. Ian Erica, a great Uishla, Foyd arrived, could he and Sharman a shot and run for Dov Octany or the Dakush or Aulamorian Kalashta. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this graduation ceremony at which third level awards will be conferred on learners of Griffith College. Our panel members include Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, Ronald Fenlon, Director of Griffith College, Dr. Wasim Akhtar, Head of Computing Science Faculty, Barry Denby and Dr. Fahim Bukatwa, Programme Directors in Computing Science, John McDonough, Programme Director of the College's Engineering Programmes. We welcome Jim O'Sullivan, President of the Irish Institute of Industrial and Systems Engineers, and Dr. Orla Hanratty, Head of the College's Teaching and Learning Faculty, along with senior members, lecturers, directors, e-learning technologists, learner support staff involved in the delivery and support of our programmes. I'm Dr. Thomas McGuckagon. I'm the College's Director of Academic Programmes, and I'm delighted to have the pleasure of being your MC for this graduation ceremony. Kantusa Korlesh Himakti, Irminish Erin Tullif, Dermot Hegarty, Uchtaron Kalashti Griefa, Lauertling, Hakianon Kalashta. We'd like to begin the proceedings by inviting Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, to deliver a conferring address.
Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, colleagues, graduates, and ladies and gentlemen, and of course, all of those who are watching this ceremony, which is currently being live-streamed on the internet. Over 200, I understand, are watching. Graduates, today is your day at the mountaintop. Now the whole world is before you. Here, you are awarded with a clear vision of the way ahead. Do remember that the reason you climb so high is to understand how small the world is around you. This is truly the global viewpoint, which we hope to have given you here in this global village, Griffith College. Today is your day, so treasure this special moment. It will live vividly in your memory for many years to come. An academic award is not an entitlement of rank or class. It is earned through many hours of mental toil and diligent application. No one can take this from you, so wear your gowns with pride and hold your qualifications in the high esteem they deserve. While today is your day, as we celebrate your success, we should pause to give thanks to those who've contributed to it. Now, in the time-honored tradition of Griffith College, I'm going to ask the parents, families, partners, and friends to stay seated while you, the graduates, stand up. Now, I'm going to ask you, the graduates, to turn back to your parents, partners, families, and friends, and express thanks for the support you've received over the years of your study by acclamation, applause, or cheers, whatever way you like. You may now sit down. Well, let me congratulate the cheerleaders from the audience who actually led that led that cheer. I have to say, if anybody asked me how the graduation speech went, I'd be able to say it was interrupted by applause. So as president of the college, you would wish me to acknowledge the work of my colleagues as members of board, heads of faculty, lecturers, administrators, and librarians, whose work contributed to your success today. I'm delighted to welcome our distinguished guests, our educational colleagues, Declan Hannigan and Therese Hannigan, David Carpenter, Dermot McDermott, Deirdre Heffernan, Patricia O'Sullivan, and board members from Bank Street Hospital, Dr. Eamon McGuinness, and also Dr. Peter. From our campus development advisory team, I'd like to welcome John Spain, Len Noonan, and Michael McGowan. And the Irish Cavalry Squadron, Michael Buggy. We also welcome Donica Curley and Jamie White, and Gerard Gilmartin and Trevor Anon. While the global village is now yours to inhabit, pessimists may tell you that globalization leads to the transfer of jobs through offshoring, abandonment of culture, to exploitation and depletion of natural resources, to the rise of multinationals at the expense of indigenous SMEs and of the national exchequer, and to the weakening of regulation. The former Secretary General of the UN, Ban Ki-moon, expressed our responsibilities in this world quite well when he said, "We are the first generation to be able to end poverty and the last generation that can take steps to avoid the worst impacts of climate change. Future generations will judge us harshly if we fail to uphold our moral and historical responsibilities." Christians among us might put it this way: "Remind us, Lord, as we sit down to eat, of fishes, loaves, and water turned to wine, these miracles that you each day repeat, as sun and earth give life to your design. As we sit down to eat, we should remember that we must sustain and share these miracles of creation." In response to this, some of you will say, we should turn our backs on globalization. However, the optimists among you will acknowledge that these challenges create great opportunities. Remember, you're already globalized. Your car is probably German, your vodka Russian, your pizza Italian, your kebab Turkish, your democracy Greek, your coffee Brazilian, your tea Tamil, your curries Indian, your electronics Chinese, and also your numbers are Arabic, your letters are Latin, and particularly remember today, your education is Irish in this island of saints and scholars. Is the challenge then to accept that ours is a globalized world, but to limit its destructive effects? Should we travel less by air, cycle to work, eat less meat, refuse to buy our food plastic packed, or is there an alternative? Now, it's your job to be the innovators, to find the alternatives that will allow you to maintain your current lifestyles, but in a more sustainable way. As you launch on exciting careers, and I do my best to depress you, I'm reminded of the patient who confided in his surgeon, "I'm very nervous, doctor. This is my first operation." To which the surgeon responded, "I know how you feel. It's my first, too." But look at these challenges as Henry Ford did. We're all faced with a series of great opportunities disguised as impossible situations. Sustainability presents opportunities for you, such as finding biodegradable plastics, cheap production and storage of hydrogen for transport, nuclear fusion to address our power needs, inventiveness in bioscience, enabling meat production without carbon emissions. There are opportunities for you as facilitators and managers of these processes, not just as inventors. And if you've facilitated or managed any one of these problems, you'll probably come back as a distinguished alumnus, having bought Greenland. Let's face it, we're all entitled to our trump card. But your trump card is surely your cultural globalism, where you've enhanced each other's cultures, you've made long-term friends with different cultures, and some may end up in long-term relationships or marriage. If you do get married, do engage a Griffith qualified photographer. We award them their degrees tomorrow. And that's to protect against the mishap occurring to a couple who had their photographs taken outside the church. And after the wedding, as they admired the photographs of the happy bride and groom, the bride with her family, the groom with his family, and all their friends and relations, they noticed one common backdrop to all the photographs. It was a sermon of Easter week on a big notice board outside the church. Forgive them, Lord, they know not what they do. So if you do have a partner with a different language, please know to do this. Keep both languages and cultures alive in the family home. Celebrate your legacies. Embrace your cultures. And then you will enrich and be enriched. I'd like to welcome in their own languages the families and friends that have traveled to Ireland to be with their sons and daughters today from India, Pakistan, Germany, and Brazil. Bartje Chatro. Me apka or apke karwanunka. So wa. So I get Katarhun. Pakistani Talabilmo. Mapko or Apke Karwanunko. Kursham deed Katarhun. Deutschen Studenten. Wir begrüßen alle unsere deutschen Studenten und ihre Familien, die gekommen sind, gemeinsam mit ihnen zu fahren. Estudantes brasileiros, eu gostaria também de desejar boas dias aos países. Familiares e amigos de nossos estudantes brasileiros. Computing science is an incredibly dynamic discipline. The computing faculty continues to develop and grow and deliver programs and modules in specialized areas. Growth of the IT sector in Ireland continues with recent news that work on a new Amazon data center is to begin as soon. And that follows other data centers built recently by Facebook and others. And also news that interest endures from multinational IT companies to set up operations in Ireland. Our computing science graduates' readiness as IT specialists is evident from their projects, which range from predicting house prices, network threat detection backed by machine learning, and modeling how computer viruses self-modify to evade detection tools. Education websites, mobile apps to help busy parents, and rich interactive websites that explore such topics as sustainable living, the fight against climate change, and we expect to see more applications of machine learning and artificial intelligence based on platforms such as IBM Watson, Google TensorFlow, DeepMind, Microsoft's Azure Machine Learning, and robotic process automation to improve productivity and achieve enhanced digital transformation. The college is committed to supporting the requirements of the Irish IT industry, and this is evident by the variety of programs being offered in the faculty. Most of us are laymen and will not be familiar with the meaning of the technical terms I have mentioned. But as parents and families look on the bright side, this is a clear indication of the depth to which our graduates are prepared for their industry. We also present today academic awards to our graduates in industrial engineering. Industrial engineering requires its practitioners to continue learning new things longer after the formal education ends. This has never been truer than in today's world. We've seen an accelerated pace of innovation in developed countries growing exponentially. And Griffith College industrial engineering students benefit from the wide range of experience and expertise in industrial engineering from lecturers who are at the front of delivering innovation to companies across Ireland. Companies from Intel, Johnson & Johnson, Alstom Transport Ireland to Cahill Cheese require industrial engineers to drive their competitiveness through application of techniques like Lean and Six Sigma, constraint management, ROI, waste elimination, and project management. These are all parts of the modules that form the basis of the industrial engineering program. The industrial engineering graduates' ability to immediately create added value to their company is demonstrated in their capstone projects. Number of cases, there have been savings of over 250,000 identified and delivered to their company. The areas of improvement include improved safety, reduced workload, increased throughput, costing and cost savings through all of it. The capstone projects have provided accurate detail and a level of professionalism that demonstrates their new abilities. The college is also in partnership with these new employer companies when developing and updating the program to provide effective engineers ready for the challenges of the 21st century. We also present today academic awards to our graduates in our training and education programs. Education, and specifically learning, is impacted by an increased globalized society. Graduates of the training and education program have explored many issues arising from globalization, both within formal and accredited learning environments, within higher education and workplaces as well. Also, more formal environments. Key areas for exploration, included how best to support learner diversity and the use of technology-enabled learning strategies. A common objective across all training and education programs is to allow leading-edge theories and concepts of training and education to inform dynamic and engaging pedagogies. This highlights the emphasis on the graduate to identify and apply flexible approaches to learning to support the context and to support a diverse range of learners. The key word here is dynamic. Globalization world of learning is dynamic and unpredictable. Graduates of our training education programs have proven themselves to be agile and adept at selecting and using a variety of learning strategies to support their learners, who may be here on campus, online, or in a multinational workplace. Globalization and training and education impact on one another through mutual goals, of preparing learners for successful experiences wherever they are. Ireland's capacity to cope through education with rapid change has led to great success for Ireland and will lead great opportunities for you. We have in Ireland all of the top 10 global technology companies, 18 of the world's 25 top med tech companies, 18 of the 20 top pharma companies. 7.5% of Ireland's workforce is in high technology sectors, outstripping the EU average of 4% and putting Germany into second place. Our non-EU bachelor's degree certificates can work in Ireland for 1 year and our master's graduates for 2 years. They join a non-national workforce, which is double the EU average. Griffith College is delighted to be involved in exciting initiatives whereby learners work while learning. It started with Springboard, where the college repeatedly wins tenders and which helped reduce unemployment from 15% to 5.4% in 5 years. They followed apprenticeships, Griffith being awarded the national apprenticeships for health carers and bar managers. And I do believe the apprenticeship of health carers will be a major development, uplifting the standard of care in the direct line for patients throughout the country. And it will roll out to a countrywide apprenticeship, I have no doubt. Under a similar initiative in its second year, school leavers work by day in the central bank and pursue under scholarship a Griffith Business Studies degree by night. Typically 500 schoolgoers applied for 8 of these scholarships annually. Now that you're part of the Griffith alumni, don't hesitate to set your sights on the pinnacle of your profession. Your standards are set by fellow alumni who last year took 19 prizes and so far this year have again taken 25 prizes across all accounting body examinations. These include a first place and a second place in specific ACCA papers and 4 other places in the top 15 for among 503,000 students in 179 countries throughout the world. Just think about it. First in the world of 500,000 students. Quite an achievement. They've also obtained 11 first places in the CPA examination in 2018 and 13 first places in 2019. They also include 9 past presidents of the Institute of Chartered Accountants in Ireland. Also commendable are the previous graduates in law who took 53 prizes in the Law Society entrance examinations in recent years. But we too here at Griffith College have to make a difference. And key to the value of your award today will be our national degrees becoming Griffith College degrees under delegated authority to make our own awards, which we expect to come soon. There should follow university status, now open to Institute of Technology through amalgamation. And given our size, this should be open to us. But we too have to have faith. As you glimpse the world from your current mountain peak, let me leave you with the challenge of sustainability expressed in these words. Remind us, Lord, how short the span of life. Our pleasures, like ourselves, are sure to die. And they will not beget our children's strife if we just cherish water, earth, and sky. From this reference, you will gather, I'm about to conclude, with immense relief, I note. To all graduates, may I express the hope that over your period with us, Griffith College will have found a place in your hearts as you have in ours. I want you to know you're always welcome on campus, socially, educationally, or just to show off the new BMW. I did say your cars were German. May I conclude by congratulating you on your success and by wishing that you may harness the knowledge and experience you've acquired in Griffith College to achieve what you richly deserve, a successful and fulfilling career. Thank you.
Anish, but while in Fáilte Corroib, could he encourage you the no-coid in a run for a colleague, the Náisiúnta, agus Idar Náisiúnta, or Vic Lane and Coláiste. I welcome you now to the part of our proceedings at which national and international awards will be conferred on students of the college, and I declare open this awards ceremony. Iremarin Tullav Dear Integrity, Octoron Coláiste Grefa, colleague, the Náisiúnta, agus Idar Náisiúnta, Vrunna, Erna Fowlamori, Atadar Herbert, Egan Coláiste. I call upon Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, to confer awards on the learners of this college presented by the college for that purpose.
As people assemble to receive their awards, let me explain the significance of this moment. Obviously, all of our graduates here today have clearly earned their entitlement to the award that they're about to receive through many years of hard work and diligent application. But it is actually, this is the moment at which you cease to be what I referred to earlier as graduands, which is in the Latin form, those in course of graduation, and now, from now on, we'll refer to you as graduates, those who have graduated. And it's this process of conferring the award upon you that changes your status from graduand to graduate. So graduates, congratulations. Har cean caloiste I grifa, agus corla diarbhú calicta agus calicta éireann. Bronam calicta, a fiall mori an caloiste, a bhain caid an amach I lechna calicta. Agus irim gagurtu, ni fiall mori, fuim of roed, chon gar fedalam a gwyd par a chorbert doiv go formul. For the benefit of some of us, or some of our audience who do not have English as, or Irish as their mother tongue, can I repeat this in the English language? On behalf of Griffith College and Quality and Qualifications Ireland, I hereby confer the awards on the learners of the college who have achieved the standards determined for those awards, and I ask that those learners be presented to me so that I may formally present them with their parchments. Heartiest congratulations to you all.
Barry Denby, Stuart Clore, Irahori, Undive, Riveracta, a Herbert. I call upon Barry Denby, Programme Director, to present candidates in respect of the College's Faculty of Computing Science programmes.
As they stand before us today, this group of graduands have shown great aptitude, determination and desire to enhance their skills and become skilled practitioners of computer science. In this group, I've seen people study and apply themselves despite being far away from home, others who have worked full-time jobs and still had the energy and determination to study at night and weekends, and some amazing people who during their studies welcomed new members into their families and still carried on to complete and graduate today. I do have one final lecture for computing graduates, however. I promise it will be short and I won't be grading you on it. Today does not mark the end of your learning, but rather the beginning. Computer science evolves, changes, and revolutionizes at a rapid pace. You possess the skills to be at the forefront now, but also the skills to keep you there. Keep your passion for learning and for doing the hard things, as for astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson once said, for every hard thing you accomplish, fewer people are out there doing the same thing as you. And in the limit of this, everyone beats a path to your door because you're the only one around who understands the impossible concept or who solves the unsolvable problem. Presidents, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed programs in the computing science faculty and who are worthy of the QQI awards, and I request you present their parchments to them. For the higher certificate in science in computing, I call upon Daniel Farrell. For the Bachelor of Science in Computing, I call upon Marcus Jewell. Kim Hee Ng. Udo Schwabe. Maciek Staczak. Michelle Widmeyer. And Stefan Wirtz. For the Bachelor of Science Honours in Computing, I call upon Lucas Becker Ferreira. Sojanya Bohara. Stephen Brady. Dale Brady. Neil Chansey. Joseph Cheevers. Declan Coffey. Luke Cullen. Aurelien Delaguillem. Jorge Donsu. Alexandre Dutier.
Thanks.
Christopher Eviston. Paul Featherston. Yeah. Henrik Emil Raphael Huteman. Colm Hughes. Ryan Hughes. Andrei Kodzinski. Jack Kinsella. Greg Klassen. Stephen Lau. Jennifer LeBron. Arthur Lima. Tohiru Omoloi. Paul O'Neill. Christian Pajtasev. Guillermo Penamarino. Ennio Poschia. Mohamed Noman Sanuda. Anil Sebastian. Poonam Shrestha. Gurchan Singh Sikka. Felix Stanline. Gary Thomas. And David Warren. For the Higher Diploma in Science and Web Development, I call upon Humberto Barbosa de Moray. Bianca Bursan. Ashling Balger. Marcia Fritzen. Christian Alec Gariando. Chris Gleason. Mark Hickey. Orla Moriarty. Chester Santos. Vania Schneider. Colin Sharkey. And finally, Maria Viscontate.
Iriminish Erin Dr. Fahim Bukatwa, Stuarahor Clore. Irahori Irakame on Dive Reverukta occur in our Lahar. I call upon Dr. Fahim Bukatwa, Programme Director, to present postgraduate and master's candidates in respect of the college's Faculty of Computing Science programmes.
Thank you. Today, I wish to congratulate you for the effort you have put over the past year or few years, and the success you have achieved. All of us here are delighted that you have played, that we may have played some part in this success of yours. I hope we helped put you on this stage, and from now on, for you, the sky is the limit, so go for it. We may or may not see you here again in the near future, so we wish you the very best of luck in life. But if you feel you need another boost, academic boost, to help you reach further up in the sky, we are here and you can count on us. President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed programs in the Computing Science Faculty and who are worthy of the QQI Awards. And I request you to present their parchments to them. For the Higher Diploma in Science in Computing, I call upon Hitesh Behatia. Merv Belgic. Kash Singh Ravinder Shibber. Esma Gizmi Digrimensi. Temedeo Kalawali Isan. Marcia Ferreira Tobias. Thank you. Anish George. Yes, Melvina Jolly. Darren King. Okay. Erdogan, Perke, Kokar. Akshay Kokari. Lucas Maximo Marcos Veganerio. Thank you. Unomo Luis Mayocchio. Kamakshi Bimil Mehata. Mehta. Zain al Abidin Muhammad. Peter Oluwatemelhin Ujo. Samarth Shekhar Barkik. Sorry. BSc. BSc. Diploma. Who is the next person? Okay. Srihasha Sidharama. Leave it to last. Olison Taylor. Pangav Tumar. Mandela Shoko Uwiki Okupe. Abhishek Vidisagar. Ashwin Reddy Yudagori Sandinith Joseph. Merci. And for the MSc in Computing, I call upon Samit. Masroor Ahmed. Gregory Albizati. Maximilian Anus. Gio Baby. Clinton Linus De Silva. Wilson Camilo Gomez Cristanco. Faiz Mustafa. Shubhan Nitil Patel. Sabaz Sharif Narapoli. Sorry. Prakash Sandy. Michael Oloese Sobande. Ahmed Zishan Zahir. Gaurav Shyam Sander Yedia. Okay, we're going to check the same person again. Shoria Mujomad Damar. Shoria Mujod Dar. Forgot about it. Thank you.
Irmanish Erin Doctor Wasi Mactor Count Dive Irahori Irkema on Dive Reverta according to her. I call upon Dr. Wasim Akhtar, Head of Faculty, to present postgraduate and master's candidates in respect of the following programmes: postgraduate diploma and master's of science in applied digital media, and postgraduate diploma and master of science in big data management and analytics.
President, graduates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Computing Science faculty, I extend enthusiastic congratulations to our graduates. We applaud your achievements and wish you great opportunities and success in your future endeavors. It has been a great privilege to witness your progress, and it is a great pleasure to see you graduating today. This is an exciting time to graduate with skills in the fields of computing science, artificial intelligence, big data management, and digital media technologies. A majority of our graduates have completed their industry internship as part of their studies. It is a pleasure to receive feedback from the employers stating, please send similar students next year again. This group of students faced significant challenges juggling the pressures of life, be they part-time student juggling full-time work, full-time student juggling a house full of children, or our international students who may be thousands of miles from their family and friends. This is indeed a great achievement. Well done to you all. Some of our learners, as the program director Barry Denby mentioned, some of our learners who are graduating today became parents during their time with us. Well done indeed. Yes, today is an important day. Today you have achieved a major milestone. However, the journey has just begun. The path from where you are now to that dream job that you aim to get and to that career that you intend to build, it's not going to be a straight path. You cannot Google it for directions. And there is no assignment brief for that. You will have to find and sometimes carve that path yourself. You will come to crossroads where you will have to choose the path that is right for you. Let your passion guide you on such occasions. There are going to be dead ends where the path ceases to exist. Use your will to carry on and let your imagination create new realities. Adopt blue sky thinking and aim for the innovations that are free from the constraints of old-fashioned realities. However, as Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu suggested hundreds of years ago, be careful. Watch your thoughts, they become words. Watch your words, they become actions. Watch your actions, they become habit. Watch your habits, they become character. Watch your character, it becomes your destiny. President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed programs in the Computing Science faculty and who are worthy of the QQI awards, and I request you to present their parchments to them. For MSc in Applied Digital Media, I call upon Uzgun Ademan. Adebola Adewale. Rosario Albina. Farouk Abeyomi Ayof. Hera Basit. Berat Beram Pinar. Miguel Canton Sione. Monica Zichka. Thiago Dos Santos Javier Duarte. Maria Helandra Duenes Tarsius. Umaiza Iker. Jose Emmanuel Jimenez Lara. Samson Alobotabi Kagoro. Muhammad Hassan Khan. Zhu Wei Liang. Sanjeev Maharajan. Malele Martinez. Patricia Mayer Camarina. Wo Hong Ann Nguyen. Daniel Onedikaji Aboko. Amika Onwubu. Florence Pu-Yu Quinn. Maria Isabel Pulida Lara. Shima Taj Gardoon. Neil Walsh. Jung Hee Yoon. For Master of Science in Big Data Management and Analytics, I call upon Anshul. Ole Jerome Nicholas Abidayo. Olebode Peter Ademola. Mert Altintas. Tarun Savarab Anachi Ravachandran. Divya Sharon David Chilaka. Chris Michael De Silva. Anshika Garg. Nasir Ghaffar. Aaron Gonzalez. Ali Mehroz Akram. Raghavindnar Kalyarasi Ravi. Nuburak Kariaka. Siddhi Gajanan Kate. Sandeep Malayalam. Liston Lucia Muskaranhas. Darsh Niraj Mururaka. Mukesh Hansikate Nagabhushan. Biju Naina. Pamela Nina Flores. Aaron Dion Pinhario. Sangamitra Ravi. Anthony Kevin Seagar. Rashi Om Shah. Adarsh Shukla. Bijoy Simon. Woo! Gaurav Singh. Mukesh Sivathanu. Ashtar Samson Solomon. Ravi Teja Siri Ramanini. Jubin Thomas. Ada Patience Amuro. And for postgraduate diploma in science in big data management and analytics, I call upon Debduta Paul. Bhavna Sandhu. And for a Master of Science in Big Data Management and Analytics, Shubhan Manoj Mangarti. Saniya Sudhakar Biranjdar. Gaurav Saini. Puneet Kumar Lokesh. For higher diploma in science in computing, I call upon Samarat Shekhar Parikha. We say in Arabic, Mabruk atamanna lakum at-tawfiq fil mustaqbil. And we say in Urdu, bahut bahut mubarak, mustaqbil ke liye bahut si duaein, which means congratulations and best wishes for the future.
Iriminish are John McDonough, Stiorahor Clore Inilthorokta, Irahoria Herbert. I call upon John McDonough, Programme Director, to present the candidates in respect of the college's Industrial Engineering degree programme.
President, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, graduates of the Bachelor of Industrial Engineering. Welcome. Our first graduate was conferred with her degree in 2016, and today we'll see 27 proudly walk on stage to be handed the parchments that signify the necessary course of study has been successfully completed, and the graduate is qualified and ready to play an active role in the field of industrial engineering. This program is now running both in Dublin and Limerick with four cohorts enrolled. Each cohort has a full complement of students, giving their employers the benefit of what they've learned within months of starting the program. A significant number of companies are sending their students to us every year, growing their in-house industrial engineering capability and expertise. Part of the reason behind their success is the techniques of industrial engineering are extremely practical and almost immediately part of the company's improvement programs. Industrial engineers play a key role in the management of complex systems of equipment, change leadership, quantifiable knowledge, and return on investment to provide competitive advantage and future growth. You are leading the way to enabling that future. of the business through the use of those qualifications. We've come a long way since the start of this journey of learning, which you've all made with us. Your family and friends should be very proud of your achievement in opening up an opportunity and career for engineering and management. All of you are about to become industrial engineers. Well done. This is no small accomplishment. Now, I can look forward to working with you as fellow members of the Institute of Industrial and Systems Engineers, where Jim and myself can watch your careers grow and develop. President, I now present you with the following candidates who have successfully completed the Bachelor of Engineering, and I would ask you to present their parchments. John Aiken. Peter Birmingham. Gemma Burns. Jared Byrne. Larry Byrne. Gopi Danu. Rafael de Morris Pipixo. John Dennehy. Nicadazo Del Zello. Andrew Hickey. Mark Kavanaugh. Andrew Lestrange. Darren McGarry. Lee McQuillan. Jason Merriman. Nalu Ramfu.
Good job.
Marco Trance. Barry Welsh.
Anish Iramaran, Dr. Orla Hanratty, Count Diva, Mick Lane on Gorsa Diploma Trainola August Idukish a Herbert. I call upon Dr. Orla Hanratty, head of the college's teaching and learning faculty, to present the candidates in respect of the college's training and education programs.
President, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and graduates. A ship in harbour is safe, but that's not what ships are built for. This quote is from John A. Shedd in 1928, but it's so appropriate for the field, or indeed the seas and oceans of training and education today. In the globalized world of training and education, our graduates here today are seafarers, ready to take on any challenge. We are celebrating these graduates as they chose to take on the challenge of postgraduate study in training and education. They chose to move out of the safe harbor of their comfort zones and face the challenges of the open seas. They chose to engage in these programs, not just to inform and critique their own practice of learning and professional development, but ultimately to support others' learning and development. They're all professionals in roles in the areas of training and education, whether lecturers here in Griffith College or other higher education institutions, leading professional development in companies, or indeed in both roles. But by enrolling in this postgraduate program in training and education, they also took on the role of the learner. And while we're all learners in many ways in everyday life, to take on postgraduate study requires particular bravery to open yourself up to sharing professional learning and development experiences with others through class discussions, which may be face-to-face or they may be online. But they were also submitting assignments for review. It also involves extensive reading of research literature, but also creating their own artifacts. And for those who completed the masters, they engaged in their own substantial research projects. And throughout their programs of studies, they may have navigated through some uncharted waters. They've been exposed to new learning strategies, online, and group tasks. For some, they may have been in some familiar waters, but the conditions had changed, such as a greater diversity of learners or new technologies. So we as the program team, we recognize the significant achievements of each and every graduate. We're aware of the huge commitments needed to take on and succeed in postgraduate study while also balancing work and other family life and other commitments. And while supporting your learning, we were probably not aware of all the many other competing factors which impacted on your engagement in these programs. So we have the utmost admiration for you all and congratulate you all in getting to this joyful occasion of your graduation day. We particularly acknowledge the Best Academic Achievement Award winner, Stephen Moynihan. He developed a bespoke blended learning training module for the Irish Wheelchair Association. And while we highlight Stephen's work, we acknowledge all the graduates' energy and efforts throughout all of the assignments in the various modules of the three programmes. But a distinguishing feature also of these graduates is how they supported each other. They were all in the same boat, or indeed the WhatsApp group. They supported each other to create a real collegial and collaborative approach to their learning and developed a true community of practice. Some have already returned here to Griffith College, to the campus, to brief current learners who are embarking on their dissertations this academic year. And we thank them particularly for that. So all graduates are now captains and masters of the seas. They will support others to bravely tackle whatever conditions and experiences they encounter in the exciting preparation and the embedded postgraduate diploma and special purpose certificate awards. So, President, I present to you the following candidates who've successfully completed programs within the College's Faculty of Teaching and Learning and who are worthy of these QQI awards. I request you present these parchments to them. For the Special Purpose Certificate in Training and Education, I call upon Gwen Kenny. Oisín McManus. Nadia Pascari. Sarah Ward. Thank you. Mary Whitney. For the Master of Arts in Training and Education, I call upon Hayley Farrell. Paula Hudson. Michelle Kelly. Caroline McTeague. Paul McAvoy. Aoife O'Donnell. And last but not least, Eileen Sorahan.
This concludes the presentation of the college's award candidates. Tá an as an ishig an galois to dúshin of runner or issue the diary globe bar fiaush went to mark in a good lane. The college now has the pleasure of announcing a number of prizes which are awarded to graduates who've achieved excellence in their studies. I call upon Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, to present the prizes. The first prize is awarded in respect of the BSc Honours in Computing Science. The best academic achievement on the BSc Honours in Computing Science is awarded to Ryan Hughes. The following prize is awarded in respect of the Higher Diploma in Science in Web Development. The best academic achievement on the Higher Diploma in Science in Web Development is awarded to Christian Alec Gariando. Following prizes are awarded in respect of the MSc programmes. This prize is awarded in respect of the MSc in Computing. The best academic achievement on the MSc in Computing is awarded to Maximilian Anus. This prize is awarded in respect of the MSc in Applied Digital Media. The best academic achievement on the MSc in Applied Digital Media is awarded to Sanjeev Maharajan. The final prize is awarded in respect of the MSc in Big Data Management and Analytics. The best academic achievement on the MSc in Big Data Management and Analytics is awarded to Mert Altintas. Ian Erica, Aguina Uishle, Corum Creaklesh and Sharman Isho, Kondavakhtani of Runa, or Aulamorian Kalashta, Baron Buikas Liv Galair. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the ceremony for the purpose of conferring awards on the graduates of the college. My best wishes and thanks to you all. While the graduates are here with us, I'd like to take this opportunity to briefly mention the Griffith College Alumni Network. With over 30,000 graduates living in Ireland, Europe, and in over 104 countries worldwide, the network is an excellent way to stay in touch with classmates, fellow graduates, and the college. The network is also proving to be a most valuable resource for graduates seeking or changing employment. Details about the network are available on Griffith Alumni Network and from the alumni section of the college's website. On behalf of the college, I would like to invite all of the guests of the graduates here today to enjoy a glass of wine, cup of tea or coffee, and refreshments in the college's restaurant immediately afterwards. I would also like the graduates, ask them to oblige us just for a few more moments while we capture and film just how lovely they look today. So once we've taken the photographs, the graduates can rejoin their guests and celebrate their achievements together in style. I'd also like to remind the graduates that the graduation party will be held tomorrow evening. It'll be in Copper Face Jack's in Harcourt Street, and it will start at 10 o'clock. Tickets for the event are available from the Students' Union, and we hope you have an excellent time there. Please stand for the academic procession.